Hey guys, okay, this is the last section of Unit 3, and we are talking about active transport. So when we talked about diffusion and osmosis being passive transport requiring zero energy for the body or a plant to perform those actions, active transport is exactly like it sounds. It is active and requires energy. So active transport, by definition, is the movement of particles through a cell membrane from a region of lower concentration to a region of higher concentration using energy from respiration. So if you think back to diffusion, and I talked about we were moving down a concentration gradient, active transport is moving up the concentration gradient. So with diffusion, and I told y'all to picture that slide, like when you get to the slide and you slide down, it doesn't really take you any energy to shoot on down that slide. But you can all remember, we're a kid and you didn't use proper slide etiquette that I'm trying to teach my five-year-old right now, and you start to climb up the slide. That takes energy. It's going to take activity from you. So you need energy to perform that, just like active transport. It is like climbing up the slide. And that energy does come from respiration. So when we look specifically at active transport, where it is occurring, it's occurring in plant root hairs, where substances like mineral salts and phosphates are coming from the soil and actively being transported into that root hair cell and then on into the plant where it is needed. It's also occurring in our villi of our small intestine, as well as kidney tubules. So here we typically use active transport, transporting glucose molecules. For the small intestine, it's from the small intestine into our blood plasma. And then with our kidney tubules, it is ultimately filtered into the tubule, into our blood capillaries. So this active transport for humans taking place in the kidneys, as well as the small intestine, and then for plants taking place the root hair cells. Now, when we get a visual of active transport, important to note, and there's a great depiction in your textbook that I would suggest opening up and reading on page 35. When we look at active transport, how it's taking place, our cell membranes have unique protein pumps built into them. And what this means is those protein pumps can open up, bind to the molecule that's coming in, so like this yellow dot, it can bind to the molecule and it gets that energy to bind through ATP. ATP stands for adenine triphosphate, which is our chemical form of energy that we produce when we perform respiration. So the molecule can bind to the protein pump right here that's open in this image, and ultimately flip open and pull that molecule in through active transport by using that ATP energy to get that molecule across the cell membrane. So again, definitely read this section in your textbook, look over your notes that I have provided, and we will check in again with that CFU the next time we see each other. All right, good luck, guys.